That was beautiful.
Yes.
I pray that you're being ministered to this morning. I pray that whatever care, whatever challenge, whatever burden, whatever temptation, whatever trial, that you won't take that back home with you. That you will leave it at the altar, give it to God, and leave it there. We are so precious in God's sight. Right now, I'm going to ask our only lady. Can you all remember we had a speaker and she said, I don't like to be referred to as the first lady because I'm the only lady. Can y'all remember that? So, it wasn't Sister Hill. No, it was not her. But I'm saying our only lady is coming to us right now to introduce our speaker. And so after Sister Hill is finished, the next voice you will hear will be that of our speaker, Sister Candy Williams.
Praise the Lord. I'm so glad Sister Dorothy clarified that because I don't want your opinion of me to change because I am not the only lady. Praise God. Well, have you been blessed this morning? Amen. It has truly been a blessing. And I am so excited to introduce our speaker of the hour. But before I do that, I just want us to pause for just one moment and for just 1 minute in silence. If you would just utter a prayer for Sister Judy Holman, who is in the hospital in St. Louis, Missouri. And she was transported there on yesterday, and we just want to remember her in prayer. I don't have many details, but let's just remember her in prayer. Praise God. Hallelujah. We will say a prayer on the end for her. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Yes, God. We know there's Jesus. Yes, God. Glory to God. Send angels. Yes, God. Ha! My God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. I am so full this morning. You have blessed me, ladies. And I told Tia when I heard that she was going to sing that, I said, Tia, you're just going to make me cry. Because when I hear the words of that song, you don't know the cost. Well, I'm going to introduce this again because she has a message for us this morning. I'm not preaching this morning. But women are precious in His sight. And I have the pleasure of introducing a very, very, very precious saint this morning. I've known her for a number of years, more than 30, probably going on 40 years. Let me tell you, many, many years ago, I used to go to work, and I had a certain path that I drove, and I saw these cute little girls standing over to the side of the street, one with real long hair. And little did I know at the time that she would be a part of this ministry. That was Sister Candy, a little girl, pretty, pretty little girl. She's still a beautiful lady. But since she's been a part of this ministry, Sister Candy has worked in so many different capacities. She's worked in the children's ministry. She's been the leader of the women's ministry. And I know I'm going to forget something, but she is just a real darling person. She's a student of the Word. She knows the Word and she loves the Word of the Lord. She is an intercessor. And whenever she's not here on Monday nights, you know that she has some other commitment because she really loves, she loves the Word and she loves the Lord. She is the better half of the Williams family. The other half, let me correct that. She's the mother of three gorgeous, lovely children, has a beautiful family, and just a very instrumental part of the ministry. And how many of you know Sister Candy? How many of you wish you had a temperament that, like she does? It seems like I hear some hands falling back there. She's just a joyous, well-balanced person, easy to entreat, and full of the Holy Ghost. Northside, help me to welcome our speaker of the hour, our
Even available through the internet through your cell
cell phone, praise God. And so you're constantly bombarded with all of this information. And again, it's mostly negative. They talk about crime, the rash of home invasions, rape, murders, robberies, con artists, praise God. They talk about the economy and how prices are going up and how gas is going up and how there's a shortage of produce and a shortage of oil. And they talk about layoffs and threats of layoffs and the loss of benefits like Social Security and Medicare and things like that. You just get bombarded with all this negative stuff. Even they talk about science, how the ozone layer is eroding and increasing the possibility of cancers, how the food that we grow is not as healthy as it used to be. Even though we grew it in the garden, it's not as healthy as it was back in the day. And it's enough, hallelujah, when you're hearing all of this stuff, to just kind of overwhelm you. It even talks about the inadequacies of public education, of health care, the lack of adequate health insurance. It even talks about social issues, and some of them, I have to tell you, honestly, I wonder, when they talk about it, I wonder, who cares? I mean, who really cares why Arnold Schwarzenegger and his wife, you know, are having troubles there? I mean, not so much that you don't care about it, we're concerned about it and all, but why is that noteworthy news to bring to our attention over and over and over again? We keep hearing over and over again how politicians have done things that were distrustful and all, or how they cheated on their wives. Or, and what really, really surprises me, and the one that really gets me, is you constantly hear about all these actors and actresses and how their relationships are breaking up and how things go wrong in their relationships and all. And it, I don't know why you're even surprised about it. You're talking about folks that can't even choose a mate based on who the lead lady or the lead man in the deal is, as many times as they get roles. And you know, you think that if they're studying these roles, they know that this ain't the truth that they're doing. They're portraying. They had to study it to make you come up on it. But they buying into it themselves. Hallelujah. And even though that actor had to learn the same lines that she did to do it, she thinks he's that cavalier man that's playing in there and that she can entrust her life to him. And, you know, some of the things that we hear are true, sometimes even though they're negative. There's some of them are facts, but other things are foolishness. Just like the nut who said the world is going to end last year. I mean, I heard that and I went, oh, really? I mean, what part of no man knoweth the hour do you not understand?
That's right.
Praise God. And now the